Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 4.2, Problem 2. This is Section 4.2, Problem 2. It says, find the maximum output for the simplex tableau shown below and state the value of the variables that will produce that maximum. So we have a simplex tableau given with three rows. The top row is 1, 4, 4, 1, 0, 0, 16. The second row is 2, 1, 5, 0, 1, 0, 20. And the bottom row is negative 3, negative 1, negative 2, 0, 0, 1, 0. So, to find the maximum, what we need to do is pivot this simplex tableau. So we have to find the pivot. So we find the pivot by first finding the pivot column by finding the most negative value in the bottom row. So as I look at the bottom row of this matrix or tableau, the negative values are negative 3, negative 1, and negative 2. The negative 3 is the most negative, and it occurs in the far left column or the x1 column. So my pivot will be in the x1 column. And my choices for the pivot are the 1 in the top position or the 2 in the second position or middle position. There is a negative 3 in the bottom of the x1 column, but the pivot can never be negative. So which one is the pivot? The 1 in the top of the x1 column or the 2 in the middle position of the x1 column? To determine which one, we look at our ratios of right-hand side value over pivot column value. In the top row, the ratio right-hand side over pivot column is 16 from the right-hand side over 1 for pivot column, which gives me a ratio of 16. In the second row of my tableau, the ratio of right-hand side over pivot column gives me a 20 from right-hand side over 2 from pivot column. 20 divided by 2 reduces to 10. So I want the smaller of those two ratios, smallest positive ratio. 16 or 10. The 10 is clearly smaller than the 16. The 10 came from the second row. So when I go back to my pivot column, which is the x1 column, in the second row, I have a 2. So my pivot element is a 2. So I must pivot the 2, which means turn that 2 into a 1 and turn the rest of the pivot column, which for this problem is the x1 column, turn that into zeros. So, now to make that 2 into a 1, unfortunately, I cannot just swap rows with the top row that has a 1 in the right spot. If we're just solving a matrix, we could do that. But when it's the simplex method, to turn the 2 that's the pivot into a 1, I have to multiply through by 1 over 2, and it will make some fractions. So, let's start our next tableau. When I make the 2 in the middle row into a 1, the top row will not change, so I'll just copy the top row as is. It will stay 1, 4, 4 again, 1, 0, another 0, and 16. Now the second row has a 2 in that x1 column, which is the pivot column. I need to make that 2 into a 1. So next to the row 2, I'm going to write a little equation that says row 2 is 1 over 2 times all of row 2. And it's 1 over whatever value you want to turn into a 1. So it's a 2 that we want to turn into a 1, so I multiply by 1 over 2. So 1 over 2 times 2 is 2 over 2, which reduces to 1. 1 over 2 times 1 is 1 over 2, or 1 half, does not reduce. The next value of row 2 is a 5, so 1 over 2 times 5 is 5 over 2, which again does not reduce, so 2 and a half, if you like, or 2.5, however you want to write it. The next value of row 2 is a 0, so 1 over 2 times 0 is 0. The next value in row 2 is a 1, so 1 over 2 times 1 is 1 over 2, or half. The next value of row 2 is a 0, so 1 over 2 times 0 is 0. And finally, the last value of row 2 is a 20, so 1 over 2 times 20 is 20 over 2, which will reduce to 10. And now the bottom row won't change when I'm making the pivot element into a 1, so the bottom row will stay the way it was. It will stay negative 3, negative 1, negative 2, 0, 0 again, 1, 0. And my pivot element is the 1 in the second row of the x1 column. I'll circle that just so we don't lose track of it. It's a fairly big matrix. So to complete the pivot, what I'm going to do is turn the rest of the x1 column, or the pivot column, into zeros. So I'll just keep going. I'm going to do the next tableau in a little bit of a different color just to make it stand out. So in the x1 column, which is my pivot column, in the top row I have a 1. That 1 must become a 0. So in order to make that a 0, I'm going to make a new row 1. I'm going to write a little equation next to my new row 1. And it will be row 1 equals some stuff plus the old row 1. Now I start my little equation with row 1 because that's the row that I need to make the 0 in row 1. And I end the little equation with row 1 because it should begin and end with the same row. And I left a blank spot in the middle that I referred to as stuff. Now the stuff is the row at the pivot point, which in this problem is row 2. And it will be row 2 times the same value, but opposite sign is what's being turned into a 0. So turning a positive 1 into a 0, so same number opposite sign would be negative 1. So the little equation that I'm going to use to make a new row 1 is the new row 1 equals negative 1 times row 2 plus the old row 1. And that will make my 0 and change the row. So now, in the first column, negative 1 times row 2 is negative 1 times 1, which makes a negative 1, plus row 1, which is 1. So negative 1 plus positive 1 is 0. The next column, negative 1 times row 2 is negative 1 times a half. Negative 1 times a half is minus a half. You're going to add that to row 1. So minus a half plus row 1 is minus a half plus positive 4. Minus a half and positive 4 is positive 3 and a half, which you could write 3.5 or 7 halves. I'll make it 3 and a half. The next column, negative 1 times row 2 is negative 1 times 5 halves, which is negative 5 halves, or negative 2 and a half if you prefer that. So negative 2 and a half plus row 1 is negative 2 and a half plus positive 4. So negative 2 and a half positive 4 is positive 1 and a half, or 1.5 or 3 halves, it's all equivalent. The next column, I'm going to have negative 1 times row 2 is negative 1 times 0, that's 0, plus row 1, which is 1. So I have 0 plus 1, that's 1. And then the next column over, negative 1 times row 2 is negative 1 times a half, which is negative a half, plus row 1, which is plus 0. So I have negative a half plus 0 is negative 1 half. And the next column over, negative 1 times row 2 is negative 1 times 0, that's 0, plus row 1, so 0 plus 0, which is 0. And finally, the last column, negative 1 times row 2 is negative 1 times 10, that's negative 10, plus row 1, which will be plus 16. So negative 10 plus 16 is positive 6. Now, the second row of my tableau, I don't want to change anything. The second row has a 1 in the correct position where it needs to be, in the pivot position, so I'm going to just leave the whole second row exactly as is. I'm going to copy it into my next tableau. It will stay 1, 1 half, 5 halves, which you can call 2 and a half if you like, 0, 1 half, 0, 10. I didn't have to do any work to row 2. Row 3 will need to be changed because it has a negative 3 at the bottom of the x1 column, and that negative 3 must be changed into a 0. So I'm working in row 3, so next to row 3, I'm going to write a little equation that'll tell me how to make my new row 3, and it'll say row 3 equals some stuff plus the old row 3. And again, I start the little equation with row 3 because that's the row I'm making the 0 in. And I end the equation with row 3 because it should begin and end with the same row. Now, the space I left in what I called stuff is the pivot row, the row with the pivot element, which for this problem is row 2, times the same number, but opposite sign is what's becoming a 0. What's becoming a zero is a negative 3. So same number, opposite sign is positive 3. So the little equation that I'm going to use to make my new row 3 is the new row 3 equals positive 3 times row 2 plus the old row 3. And that'll make a new row for me and make the zero where it needs to show up. So in the first column, 3 times row 2 is 3 times 1, which is positive 3, plus row 3, so plus negative 3. So I have positive 3 plus negative 3, which is 0, which is really what I wanted. The next column, I have 3 times row 2, which is 3 times a half. 3 times a half is 1.5, and I'm going to add that 1.5 to row 3. So I'm going to add 1.5 to negative 1. So positive 1.5 added to negative 1 is positive 1/2. And the next column over, I have 3 times row 2, so 3 times 5/2. So I really think of it as 3 times 2.5. 3 times 2.5 is 7.5, and I'm going to take that result and add it to row 3. So I'm going to take the 7.5 and add it to negative 2. So positive 7.5 and negative 2 is positive 5.5, or if you like 5.5, or that would be 11/2. I'll write 5.5, but it's positive. And the next column, you're going to have positive 3 times row 2 is positive 3 times 0, which is 0. Plus row 3, which is plus another 0. So 0 plus 0 is 0. The next column over, you have positive 3 times 1/2, which 3 times 1/2 is 1.5. Plus row 3, so plus 0. 1.5 plus 0 is 1.5. And the next column over, 3 times row 2 is 3 times 0, which is 0. And then plus 1. The value in row 3 is 1, so 0 plus 1 is 1. And the last column, 3 times row 2 is 3 times 10, which is 30, plus row 3. So you're going to have 30 plus 0. 30 plus 0 is 30. Now, the question is, am I done, or do I need to pivot again? The answer is I'm done, and the reason why I'm done is there are no more negatives in the bottom row. That's how I know I'm done. There are negatives in other places in the matrix, but as long as it's not in the bottom row, that's okay. So the fact that I have no negatives in the bottom row of my tableau tells me that I have found the maximum. And the output is in the bottom right position of the matrix. We started with an output of 0 initially, and after one pivot, that output went from 0 to 30, and I can see that I just can't make it any bigger. 30 is as big as it's going to get. So the problem did say, what are the values? What is the maximum? And what values of the variables will give you that maximum? So maximum of 30 when x1 equals. So for my final tableau, if I go to the x1 column, the fact that it has a special column of all zeros and a single 1 is telling me that x1 has a value. So the height of the 1 in that special column is in the middle. So when I go to the last column, the RHS column, at the same height, that middle height is a 10. So my value of x1 is a 10, because the height of the 1 is at the height of the 10 in the RHS column. So maximum of 30 when x1 is 10. x2 equals, so my final tableau in the x2 column, I do not have a special column of all zeros in a single 1. So the value of x2 is 0. x3. In my final tableau, when I look in the x3 column, I do not have the special column of all zeros in a single 1 for x3. So the value of x3 is also 0. So we have a maximum of 30 when x1 is 10, x2 is 0, and x3 is also 0. And if you're curious, you can state the values of the slack. You don't have to. The s1 has a special column of all zeros in a single 1. The 1 in that column is in the top. So the value of S1 is 6, because in the top of the RHS column is a 6, the same height as the 1 in the S1 column. S2, the S2 column of my final tableau, does not have a special column, so the value of S2 is 0. But you don't have to put the S, but the X you have to state.